I think Mexico has lost the spot as the top country in a CONCACAF. With Tata Martino, like, for me, I was like, I'm a patient guy. I was like, yeah, you know what? Bro. Let him cook.
Nah,
he
bro.
Burned the whole kitchen.
Nah, bro. That's
he burned the kitchen.
What's the best stadium you've been to?
I wish I could say Azteca. But it's not. I think Azteca, as with its history, it's amazing on the outside. But as when I was telling you on the inside, it's like you're like literally crack. Like, I feel like I think it's more comfortable in a bus.
It's more comfortable
in a bus. But the best, no doubt, Mercedes-Benz.
Wow.
No doubt.
Wow.
No doubt.
I know you wanted to wrap that shit. Welcome, welcome. You are now tuned in to the EPB podcast. It's your host, Matt Marshall, as usual. And I'm joined with a special guest, my boy, Leo Hernandez.
What's up, man?
It's you might also know him from TikTok as, what is it, the soccer guy now? El soccer guy. Yeah. Instagram too, right?
No, it's just Leo.
Come on, you got to synergize the
I know,
content,
I know, I know.
Media.
I'm thinking about it. I don't know. I'm still not sure about it. It's like my personal one.
Exactly. You want to like get a business one? Well, this guy is hilarious. He's got hella followers on TikTok. I met you because we are now both for the first year, right? First year LAFC members.
Actually, this is my sixth year. I've been
goddamn, you from the jump.
I've been a member since day one.
No way. Yeah, you're a day one. Okay, yeah. So I really need you to help me like become an LAFC fan.
Oh no, yeah, definitely.
Because as you can see, I have an Atlanta United flag still hanging in the
that's
the
room. Fine. I love Atlanta.
Yeah, forever. Yeah, exactly. Forever he loves Atlanta. We were talking off camera and I wanted to hear your story. You've actually been to an Atlanta United game.
Yes, I have, yes.
And how was that in the Georgia, like Mercedes-Benz Stadium?
Honestly, I've been to a lot of stadiums. I think I've been to maybe 10 stadiums in total.
Yikes.
And Mercedes-Benz is my all-time favorite. I've been to SoFi. It's brand new. I love it. But
yeah, I like
Mercedes-Benz is something else. Like right when I walked in, I was like, damn, I love it.
Fire.
I love it, yeah.
Bro, I have not been for one. So the reason I have this flag is because I'm from Atlanta originally. And my mom got this when they didn't even become members. It was just like by proximity. They like sent out flags to
people. Okay.
And then she sent it to me. She was like, whatever. But I've never been, and I've always wanted to go, and like I'm waiting for a good time to like go home, maybe see LAFC versus Atlanta, something like that.
No, I went to their first home game. They're one of their home openers. My cousin lives out there, so I told him, like, hey, let me go out. I think LAFC had an away game at that time, so I was like, hey, let me go visit you. Let's go to an Atlanta game. I'll buy the tickets.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, and we went, and I think it was like a record. When they opened up, it was like a home opener record. I don't know. I think Charlotte broke it. I don't know.
Yeah. Charlotte. Yeah. I mean, Charlotte came out of nowhere. But I mean, these records are now like well into like the 70s. Matter of fact, let's look that up. That's another thing I do on this podcast all the time. I'm just Googling and fact checking everything.
I was really surprised about Charlotte because I never expected like they would go that big. But then their first home game, I think it sold out. It broke a record, and they still keep doing it, which is even more impressive.
They don't have, I guess, what do they have? The Hornets basketball there.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, like they don't have much though. They like and I will say, just playing around the country, that North Carolina is like has a rich soccer kind of culture there. Yeah, it's honestly the obscure ones that I would say is like Atlanta. Like nobody knows that they play soccer in Atlanta, but they play heavy in Georgia. But you know, but the culture is dope there. Charlotte. Minnesota, I've been there and I was like, oh yo, they have a lot of like East Africans, Eritreans, Ethiopians out there, so big culture there. Texas, I think that's pretty obvious.
Yeah.
It's proximity to Mexico, whatever. Obviously California, all of California. They got some Seattle, random. Seattle. Have you ever been to Seattle?
I've been there too.
Bro, okay, first of all, this man has been to like stadiums on stadiums in the U.S. and Mexico and outside.
I'm actually trying to go to Europe September to go see some games.
Hey.
So my goal is to, you know, I manage an account called El Tri Only, which we talk about just Mexican players, Mexican teams, the national team.
Yeah.
So for that, but mostly for myself, I want to go see the Mexican players in Europe and just get the full experience and see how it is, see how football is.
Football. Yes.
But yeah, that's my plan for this year.
Yeah, that's going to be dope.
Yeah.
You're going to see like Chucky.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm actually more excited to go to the Netherlands because our best players, I don't know if you know Santiago Jimenez, he's like 21 or 22.
Yeah, the young boy. Is he a winger? What is he?
He's a striker, and he has 18 goals in his first season right now.
Yo.
And I think he's two goals away from tying Chicharito. For first season in Europe.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Or
yeah.
Best season in Europe, one of those two.
Yeah.
So I think he'll break that record. So it'll be something nice to look forward to this year.
He's playing for Feyenoord now in Rotterdam.
It's funny because I never knew that team existed until he landed there. I just know about Ajax and PSV.
Exactly. That's all you know. But yeah. Feyenoord is, and I think they're like first in the standings in the Eredivisie.
I think they have like a 4-5 point
lead right now.
Yeah.
They're big balling. Shout out my boy Giannini. He's from Rotterdam. He talks about Feyenoord all the time. Oh, yeah. Like I gotta let you meet him.
Okay, that's good.
And he's a world traveler. He's a professional dancer. Ooh. He gives great recommendations for going to Europe. Like he set me up at this crazy party in Rotterdam when I went a couple years ago. Yeah, it was nuts. So yeah.
We gotta connect.
Yeah, we gotta definitely connect on that. Damn, that's dope. Okay. So let's just talk about stadiums in general. Like what's, first of all, let me answer that question we had earlier. The highest attendance, the attendance record.
For MLS?
For MLS. Record was set in 2017. 73,000 spectators watched Charlotte FC. So you're right. It is Charlotte who now hold the record, which is nuts. 73,000 people.
I'm surprised.
Yeah, I'm surprised too. I could have sworn Atlanta had like something like 80.
I think
90.
They had it. Oh, no. Well,
they definitely had it in one of their seasons for sure. And then, and then Charlotte must have blown that out. Like, have you been to Charlotte Stadium, by the way?
No, I actually want to go for Leagues Cup, the tournament MLS versus Liga MX. They're going to have it in the summer.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking about going to that one, Minnesota, and maybe Miami.
I want to go to Miami too. That looks like
a good time.
I will tell you, I went to Orlando. Worst place I've ever been. It was a shithole.
Like, when I think of Orlando, I just like feel like I don't want
to
go.
Nah, you don't need to go. It's literally swamps and highways.
Really?
It was like absolute garbage. Bank of America Stadium is where Charlotte FC play. And I don't know. I didn't realize I feel like that's the Panthers stadium too. So that's why. That's a huge stadium. Because SoFi is only like 75K or something like that.
I think it's more.
You think it's more?
I think.
Yo.
I think it's 80 or 90. They're trying to.
Ooh, it could.
I think they're.
No, bro, look.
How much is it?
Because they're trying to do it for the World Cup.
Yeah, I know they're trying to add more seats.
They have to add more seats in order to like get the final there. And I don't know if they're going to be able to do it.
I don't think so.
Right now, its capacity is expandable up to 100K for major events, but minimum capacity is 70,000. So I guess they can like add stuff.
It's possible. Yeah.
How many do you, there is like a World Cup minimum. It's something like 95,000 seats you have it's crazy. We could look this up all day. What's the best stadium you've been to?
I wish I could say Azteca, but it's not. I think Azteca, as with its history, it's amazing on the outside, but as when I was telling you on the inside, it's like you're like literally, like I feel like I think it's more comfortable in a bus.
Yes, it's more comfortable
in a bus.
Like a Greyhound or like comfortable anything. Like,
I feel like you're in a. An airplane, and you got those uncomfortable seats.
Yo.
And it's just so hard to get up. And I went with my uncle because I wanted to take someone because he's an America fan too. And I had high hopes for it.
Yeah.
And it just let me down. So
yeah.
The history, it's amazing.
Such history, bro. Yeah. Like that's one of the greatest stadiums in the world. You know. But that's tough.
Yeah.
But it's been around also for a while. Yeah. Maybe people were smaller back then. Like it was just a different time.
I heard that they try to expand it, that's why their seats are so like put together.
Oh, to add more seating to though? Yeah, like
I don't know.
Yeah, just to pack people in there. Yeah. Damn. Okay. Yeah. So you wish it was Azteca, but Azteca is probably one of the worst stadiums you've been.
I think it's in between the best and the worst.
Who'd you see there?
I want to go see America versus Puebla. Liga MX playoffs. I want to say it was quarterfinals.
Okay. Yeah, that's pretty. Yeah. That's pretty big.
Yeah. Well, I heard. Well, they said that they were going to close the stadium down for renovations for the World Cup.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And then I saw, and I went in November, so I was like, I have to. No, October, and I was like, I have to go. They didn't close it. I went, and it's funny because I went back again to go see Bad Bunny in December. Yeah. I was like, it was the last time, and they didn't close it.
So they still haven't closed it.
No, so I was pretty upset.
They've got a couple of years, like, yeah. they've maybe.
But it's because for me, I was like, I have to go see the stadium before they close it, and then I'll come back when they renovate it.
Oh, yeah.
So
yeah.
I've been to there twice.
Sides.
And it's still there.
It's still a little tight in there.
But the best, no doubt, Mercedes-Benz.
Wow.
No doubt.
Wow.
No doubt.
Yo, how, like, have I not been?
Like, right when I walked in, I loved it. I even told my, when I was with my cousin, I was like, dude, I love the stadium.
What's the vibes? Is it like?
Well, the first game I went to was for a Mexico-Honduras game. It was like a friendly.
Okay. Which I'm sure was kind of lit, though.
It was lit, but it was also the worst Mexico game I've seen live. It really was. I was telling my cousin, dude, 0-0 against Honduras.
Honduras, bro.
Like bro. All respect to them, you know, but like.
No, I mean, there's levels.
I was very disappointed, but I think the stadium kind of made up for it.
Yeah. What was it like? It was like the screens and TVs. Oh, yeah.
It gives me SoFi vibes, but the thing I don't like about SoFi, I feel like, you've seen that, like, that big screen around the thing? I feel like it blocks the view to the other state.
Yes.
Yeah, right? I'm not the only one. Huh?
No, you're not the only one. Okay. Not only does it block the view, but it's not, like, all LED. There's still that black part underneath it. So it just feels like something in the way.
Yeah.
Like, regardless.
I feel like it's, I don't know. I don't know if it was the design or maybe they got lazy, but I don't like it.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan.
I don't know.
I get the technology. Yeah. Like, it's a ring.
I think it's cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's cool.
And you see the LEDs on the outside and on the inside. Yeah. So if you're sitting lower, you can see, like, the inside of the ring. And if you're sitting high, you see. But
I don't like it.
Yeah. So what is Atlantis? It's a big.
It's just screens.
It's just a big screen everywhere. Oh, shit. Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense.
And it opens up on the top of the dome.
That's what I like. Yeah.
That's even cooler. So I was like, I've never seen that, like, in person. And I think when I went, they did open it.
They did?
Yeah.
Do they open it, like, while you're there? It's, like, before.
Damn, honestly, I don't even know. I noticed. No. I just noticed it was open. I don't think they would open it.
No, I don't think they would open it. Well, I think it takes, like, 30 minutes for it to, like, fully open. Yeah. But I saw, like, a drone shot of it.
Yeah.
And it, like, twists open.
Yeah. Kinda, it's like a little flower or something. I don't know.
All right. So, okay. So far, you're up there, but Mercedes-Benz, that's the place to be.
Yes.
Damn. Okay. What, you were talking about Mexico.
Yeah.
somebody said to me the other day that, like, we have now hit a time where Mexico is maybe three in the top three of the CONCACAF teams, right? And they've they have now been kind of knocked off their perch because they were all, for the most part, always the top, maybe top two.
I agree.
How do you feel?
Well, it's disappointing because, I mean, I'm pretty sure you saw the World Cup and Mexico is probably, that's probably, like, the worst participation Mexico has ever given, like. Like, obviously, when they make it to the next round, the other World Cups that I've seen, I mean, they're always limited after that.
Yeah,
but
for
this
sure.
one was just.
But they look like a team, like, in the group stage, you're like, oh shit, this could be some noise, whatever. But
honestly,
not this
I didn't have any hopes that they were going to make it. This time.
Well,
this,
they didn't bring. They brought a pretty, like,
they
young
had,
team.
They had,
like,
a good squad, but with Tata Martino, like, I was. For me, I was like, I'm a patient guy. I was like, yeah, you know what?
Bro.
Let him cook.
He burned
the whole kitchen.
Nah, bro, that's
he burned the kitchen. I was like, nah, enough is enough. He's not gonna do well.
He burned the kitchen.
Yeah, it's. I mean, it happened.
Yeah,
And it's. I agree. I think Mexico has lost the spot as the top country in a CONCACAF.
Mm.
U.S. I want to say it's between USA and Canada right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I saw that Mexico's squad is the third most expensive. First, it's USA, and then I think second is Canada.
For, like, those
like
players
the value,
who go to club?
Yeah, the squad value.
No way.
Yeah.
They're the third most expensive?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. No. Well, shit. They need to, it's time to get these players going.
Yeah.
There are, like, a lot of, like, Mexican-American players in which I think normally they would, some players who had the opportunity to play for America would have easily chose Mexico.
Yeah.
And now maybe there's a little shift in that.
I feel like they're choosing USA now
for
over
sure.
Mexico, which I understand.
Yeah.
And I feel like there's a lot of corruption too, and all the people that are on top, I feel like they're making decisions. And I think it's very obvious now for us. For me, even for me, it's like, you know, if you're going to choose Tata Martino and then the results, but then you're going to fire him, but then you see these players that are going and they shouldn't be there, and it's like, I mean, they're not even trying to hide it, but I mean, oh, I'm still there supporting with my jersey, and at the end, it's like, why?
You know? We're still here for you.
Yeah. That's why I can't go to the mystical games anymore, just because it's like, I know what's going to happen.
Yeah, yeah. It's just not exciting.
I think I'd rather just go to Europe and spend my money there.
That's real. Watch the Mexican players, but maybe playing for better teams and stuff like that. I think I saw one of your TikToks where you were like shitting on Mexico a little bit.
Yeah.
And I was like, I can't even remember what it was, but it was just like, you're a Mexican fan right now.
Yeah, that's exactly how I feel all the time.
Yeah. What do you think about the other two, like Canada and U.S.? Like, how did you like the World Cup in general?
The World Cup, well, I'm a Messi fan, so I was, it's funny because a lot of people on Twitter are like giving Mexico fans shit because, you know, Argentina and...
For sure. You
know, right, I get it, but I was more happy for Messi than Argentina.
Of course,
everybody. So I was like, oh my God, I remember...
Yeah, forget Argentina.
There was nobody in my house, I was the only one watching the World Cup because they went to Mexico. So I was like, oh my God, you know, I'm out here trying to not cry. But I was like, yeah, but that's, I was so happy, I was like, this is something, I think... A lot of soccer fans and Messi fans really wanted to see this because, you know, the whole Ronaldo-Messi rivalry.
Yeah.
And one of them had to win it, and then Messi won it. And a lot of people were saying it was that they bought the World Cup. I mean, for me, I don't really see it. I was arguing with one of my coworkers, and I was like, dude, you really think that Argentina said, hey, let's lose against Saudi Arabia? Like,
I think
they just got lucky.
And that
I
was
think
crazy, got, by the way.
They got really confident, and it was, I remember I didn't wake up for the game. I was like, easy win. Bam. They lost.
Yes, exactly.
But
that was like one of the most craziest games. I obviously just waking up for it, but. Yeah. I will say, because I'm in the running of the two. Like, I was always Ronaldo, right? Yeah. I was always Team Ronaldo for various reasons. And seeing, first of all, I didn't think Argentina had a chance to get to. Yeah. I was hoping they would get to Brazil so I could see Neymar knock Messi out. Like, that's what I wanted to see.
That's part of my bracket.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I was waiting for that. Yeah. So I was like, man, I don't think Argentina will make it. And then they got punched in the face by Saudi Arabia. Yeah. And I was like, yo, like, this might be a wrap. So. Again, going from that point and watching the World Cup, for him to bring that team to the World Cup, and honestly, you could feel it. Like, not only was his whole team behind him, right?
Yeah.
Like, it didn't even seem like they wanted to win just to win. It was like, we need to get Messi this trophy,
that's
right?
What it was.
Like, to galvanize them, to galvanize like the country and like the world of Messi fans, you could feel that they were all behind him. Yeah. And honestly, like, they could have smacked France in the final.
Yeah, no, they, like, that was probably the best final I've ever seen for a World
best
Cup.
Best World Cup final
I never
ever.
Expected I was going to go that far. Like,
yeah.
I think that was so stressful.
That's next level. I was like, bro, after that second Mbappe goal, I was like, yo, this is crazy.
I was like, oh no.
Yeah.
I'm all gonna get excited.
And then he scores in overtime though.
Yes.
Like, yo. Yeah. So for that reason, I have now, like, I've said it on this podcast multiple times now. Like, I now, like, respect Messi as the GOAT for sure. And, like, we'll just, you know, let him be him. He's still not necessarily my favorite player. Yeah. But again, to see that, like, I've never, like, The way I would describe what I saw for his push to the World Cup is like the way like Maradona carried his team to the World Cup, or like any other, like, or Jordan doing all these things that they say Jordan did, even though I'm like, I honestly feel like LeBron is way better. But no, like, if you lived that era and felt that energy, I'm sure like it's next level tough, you know? So, yeah. All right. I give it to Messi.
Yeah,
but Mexico didn't do well. Canada didn't do well either.
No, I was surprised.
That was surprising.
I had put them up that they were going to make it
at least to the next round. Yeah. Mm. Oh, what are they doing, bro? I wanted to talk about your jersey collection. As you can see here, you've got a crazy.
It was authentic, actually.
That's authentic? Retro?
Yeah.
What? Is that Jurgen Klinsmann's year? Is that like 1986?
I can't remember the year.
Yeah.
I saw it and I was like, to get it.
No, that's clean, bro. Yeah. So you obviously on TikTok, I see like you got jerseys after jerseys. First of all, where do you get these jerseys from?
Well, I get it from different places. It's funny because I found this random website and it's a mix between like, you know, like authentic ones and just like those replicas.
Yeah.
And I just started ordering from them, and I want to say loyal for them for like the last 3 years.
Okay. Yeah.
But I started getting in contact with this page called Classic Soccer Jerseys, which is where I got
That's
it.
Where I got one of my joints.
Really?
Yeah, I think they're like out of Miami or something, or out of Florida maybe.
Somewhere around
Yeah.
there. So I was like, oh, damn. And there was some jerseys that are really pricey, and I was like, do I really want to spend $400 on this jersey?
Right. Yeah.
So I was like, let me get something decent. And then I saw this one. I was like, I could wear this at a party, at a...
You can wear
gathering.
That anywhere, bro.
Anywhere.
That's just clean.
At a podcast.
At a podcast. This is perfect yeah. for today. I wish I had someone. Yeah.
Oh, but yeah, that's where I get them. I don't really go to swap meet anymore just because I feel like they're too.
Replica.
Two replica. Lower two, replica.
Lower.
Which I don't mind, but I remember there was this girl I met on Instagram. She's like from France, and she found out that I buy. She said fake jerseys. And I was like, it's not that I don't want to buy the authentic ones. It's just that they're really expensive. And I told her the price. And I was like, that's a lot of money.
That is hella money.
Yeah,
what?
Yeah. yeah
First of all, the shade for fake jerseys. Yo, we all love our teams. Yes. We want to like, I'll never get into nobody for wearing a fake, wearing a replica. I'll say that. Unless it's like one of them, like, Bush League ones where it has like you know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Where you're like playing in deep in Pacoima and the guys have like the Ajax jersey, but it's like missing a bunch of stuff, but it's like red and white.
Yeah.
So maybe that is like a little too far, but
I like to spend on a budget.
I'm saying
like $150 for a jersey is like, damn.
That's hella, bro. Yeah, like, and they're getting more expensive. They used to be like 90.
Yes.
And then it's like
right.
120.
Okay. So
nah, bro, you're not
they
the only one.
They keep going up.
They keep going up, and it's like I can't keep up. Like, I'm impressed by the amount that you have. Yeah, like, I have.
You know, it's funny because I actually have more jerseys than regular clothes now. Like, when I try to go to work, I'm like, what do I wear? And then all I see is jerseys.
Club America, United States, Germany. But
and I was like, oh, damn, I gotta buy more work clothes.
Yeah.
But they let me wear sometimes. Well, I wear the what was with the collar?
Just a little more
casual.
Official.
Yeah. But they don't say anything, which is cool.
That's funny. Like like the Real Madrid 2015 joint with the white collar.
I'm a Barca fan. I'm sorry.
That's you know, I was going to ask you. So your European team is Barca?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Messi, of course.
Oh, actually, Ronaldinho.
Before Messi.
I got into soccer because of him. I got into Barca because of him. And then Messi came up and I was like, all right, well. I'm a follower.
Yeah. Wait, go ahead.
I'm also trying to go to camp now to go, you know, so.
That's, that one I've not seen a game. I only went to go on tour during the summer. One of the most impressive stadiums I've ever seen. The only issue is it's old as shit. They're renovating it, but it's like, it's how I imagine a slightly better version of what you said Azteca is.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that though. It's a big kind of Coliseum bowl. Like if you get to the nosebleeds, you are up there.
Really?
Like there are birds like just chilling there. Like it's just crazy.
I saw one of my friends, I think she went to a game and she was like the lower level and she said, like, I asked her, how much are the tickets? And she said, they were pricey.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, all right.
Yeah. And when she means pricey, she means like $1,200 type
up.
Shit.
That's what I'm saving up to get the best experience.
Yeah, that's crazy. Uh-huh. I saw on your TikTok that you looked at like Arsenal tickets and they were like 10,000 euros or something like that.
And that was for the MLS thing though.
Wait, what?
Yeah, because Arsenal is playing the MLS All-Stars.
Yeah.
So that's
here.
Yeah, that's here.
Oh, I thought that was at the Emirates. No.
No, that's right here.
And those weren't like box seats or like...
I don't know. I saw some girl post a screenshot on Twitter and I was like, no.
No way. No.
I mean, I'm pretty sure they put the price up there to see who buys it, but
yeah,
imagine.
That's crazy. I love soccer to death. I love watching it, but you'll never catch me dead.
Oh, no. Me neither.
And 10 grand for tickets. Unless,
Unless like Mexico makes it to the World Cup final, then you know what?
Yo, yeah.
That would be the last time.
It's like, fuck it. We doing it.
Yes. Okay, my mom would be like, who sold the house?
Yeah, exactly. Like, kicking it at the World Cup final. All right, that's not bad. But yo, 10 grand, like this is getting out of hand. You know what I mean? Yeah. I don't know. I've been to probably the priciest tickets I've paid for now was my first Champions League game, which was PSG versus Club Brugge. That's who it was.
Oh, okay.
That's not bad. It's the Belgian team.
Yeah.
But it was like a guaranteed like PSG win kind of there. And I got like really good seats. I was probably like row 5 type shit.
Really?
Yeah.
How much were the tickets?
They were like 800 a pop.
Damn.
Yeah. It was up. It was up there. Yeah. But
yeah, damn, that's gonna hurt.
Check it out. Don't got that. No, that was like a. I don't even know what happened. Matter of fact, I had accidentally bought the game before that, and those were like $400 a pop, and realized that I had gotten the wrong game. It was weird. And I speak French well.
Oh, really?
Well, too, yes. Yeah, so I was reading the website, but I guess I don't read French that well, and I was just like, did I pick the wrong game? Yeah. Found it 2 weeks later, so then the like game I needed, which was earlier than the game I bought, it ended up being 800, and I just had to eat it, bro. It was a good experience, though. Yeah. It was a good time. Talk to me a little bit about kind of how you grew up and then got into soccer, all that, because you were talking about Ronaldinho being your dude. Where'd you grow up? You grew up in L.A.?
I grew up in Santa Ana. I've been born Santa and raised Ana. There my whole life.
Shout out Santa Ana.
Yeah, 714. well, I mean, I played in high school. Ronaldinho, obviously, when I saw him, I was like, damn. I think I remember when I saw the Elastico for the first time, it took me like a month to perfect it. And I would do it at the games. I felt, you know, like badass. I was like, damn, I do it perfectly. And I would just go, like, you know, play in the park with, you know, random people. And it was cool. I loved it. Until, like, I got to college, I was trying to play for the team. Mm. For my ACL. So that pretty much ended my whole career.
No way.
Yeah, it sucked.
Yeah.
And, but after getting surgery and all that stuff, I mean, I still play it, but it's not the same.
Yeah.
Now I'm kind of, like, a little scared to get on the field just because, like, I used to play Sunday League. And there's some people that take it really, really serious.
Sunday League is dangerous. And I'm just like, dangerous.
Hey, bro, I'm here to have fun.
I just want to play. I just want to do the Elastico, bro. Yeah, like, leave me alone.
That's all I'm here for. Let me do my trick and I'll sub out.
And I'll get out.
Yeah.
Damn.
No, but it's funny because I'm like the big soccer fan in my family. Like, my family, most of them are from Hidalgo, a state in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And they are either Pachuca fans, Cruz Azul fans, or America fans. Mm. It's one of those three.
Yeah.
And Pachuca is a team from Hidalgo. So, you know, if America and Pachuca face each other, I support it's both, problems. But it's mostly America.
It's mostly America? Okay. Yeah. America is like the one squad, the first squad I ever even recognized in Mexico.
Yeah.
And it was because I was playing some youth soccer, and their youth team came up and played in a tournament. Really? And they like whooped everybody. Yeah, it was crazy. But yeah,
I saw that this famous commentator in TV Azteca, I don't know if you've heard of him. His name is Cristian Martinoli.
Mm.
But he's like the most entertaining commentator you can listen to while watching a game. And he was saying that if without America, the Mexican League would be nothing. They're like the most loved and hated team, and I agree.
Yeah, yeah.
They always say we buy the refs, which is, I feel like, it's
dude,
a big thing.
What is up in Mexico, bro?
I don't know what it is, but I've seen a lot of games, and I feel like, you know, the whole, even with VAR or whatever, it's sketchy on with every team.
Yeah.
I don't think it's just America. It's just like, I don't know.
It's just, yeah. What do you think about VAR in general?
I like it, but I hate it.
That okay.
It's
I feel like it's everybody's
it's
reaction.
It's good that it's there, but I feel like they don't use it when needs to be used. And I feel like even for me, I'm not a ref, and I feel like if I see a foul, like it's a foul.
It's a foul.
Or if it's a flop, it's a flop. But I feel like they just, I think the refs are under more pressure now, and I think it kind of messes up the game.
I agree.
I've seen so many calls where it's just like, even when I'm at a game, like an LAFC game, and they don't show the VAR, but I mean, if I see the foul like clear, like, you know, while I'm in the stands, like it's got to be a foul.
Yeah.
They don't call it a foul.
Yeah.
And then I see it on TV and it's like,
it was definitely a foul. And y'all had TV. So wait, do we have VAR in MLS? I can't even remember. Okay.
I don't know if it's MLS.
Or
no, it is an MLS. But I went to.
No, it is an MLS because we had some calls overturned.
There was a CONCACAF Champions game too. So I don't know if it's there too. I want to say yes, but I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember either. We'll look that up. We'll fact check for you guys. But yeah. I want to say maybe not in CONCACAF Champions League. But maybe in MLS. I can't even remember. Yeah. But yeah, like when I think of VAR, I think of the things that they should be looking at are things they don't look at as much, right? Like, you know, they'll just be like, oh, that's up to the ref on the field's interpretation. It's like, bro, like that's one that he couldn't see. Yeah. So you look at it for him. And then the things like the offsides is too much for me. Like the razor sharp.
Oh.
We, you know, we just measured by
like
the 13th.
Pinkies,
yeah,
like
and you're just
head.
Like, bro, like, come on now. Like,
I don't agree with the whole. I don't know if they use the arms or anything, but I mean, it wouldn't make sense to use the arms because we don't use the arms.
We don't use arms. Yeah.
So I feel like it's got to be like the knee, the leg, the foot. Like
they say it's like, and I don't, and like it, the rule changes every year, so I get confused, but the latest one is like something like the body part that is playable, that is able to be played. So I don't think they exactly use the arms, but they might use like a shoulder or some kind of lean.
Okay, well that makes sense.
Yeah, and so they use the like body part that can be played. But if you're leaning forward and he's leaning this way, but you guys are on the same line, that just means the defender just like didn't read my run, and like that should give me the advantage. So I don't know. Like VAR is next level with that shit. I don't know. So you're a day one fan of LAFC.
Yes, I am.
You told me off camera that you wanted to be a Galaxy fan.
I did. I tried.
Wait, what is this? That's the LA.
LA.
Okay, my bad.
Oh, you gotta teach me.
I was like, yeah, you gotta teach me everything, bro. Like, all right, so I'm first year LAFC member. I've been an LAFC fan since they started, and I just don't feel like I'm a part of the community yet. You know what I mean?
It's your first year, right?
It's my first year. Okay. So I got some time, but like even when I go to the stadium, I just don't feel quite at home, and it's just gonna take time, but like I wanna just be able to walk around the stadium, like, you know, just be there. But yeah, like what made you choose LAFC, especially growing up in Santa Ana? You've been closer to Galaxy for so many years.
Well, I mean, I love soccer, so I wanted, you know, as I was growing up, I had, you know, I was making money. I wanted to go see some games on my own. And, you know, Galaxy was, you know, the closest team for me.
Yeah.
So I was like, Giovanni Santos was there.
Gio.
Jonathan.
Ben is his brother,
And I was like, I'll try. I'll buy a jersey. So I bought a jersey. I'll be honest with you. I bought a jersey and I tried. But I didn't go to the game. Like, I wanted to, but it wasn't calling me. Like, I was like, I don't know. Yeah. I was forcing myself to go, but I didn't want to go.
Yeah.
And then I think like 2 years from there, they announced that they're going to make a team, another LA team.
Yep.
But they didn't announce any players. So I was like, And I remember that I wasn't making that much money around that time. And I was like, I don't know how I'm going to pay for it. So, but I put in the deposit, like, I'll find the way.
To be a member?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was a $100 deposit. And I was like, all right, I have the $100.
Yeah.
How am I going to pay for this? So I hit up some friends and I'm like, hey, you know, I became a member, like, but do you want to pitch in for the money? You know, so we shared tickets.
Yeah, smart.
And when they announced Carlos Vela, I was like, ooh, that's a big signing.
That's a huge signing, yeah.
So, you know, as they kept signing more and more players and then the coaches, I was like, oh, I can't wait. So I still remember going to the first game. It was against Seattle. I think it was against Seattle.
Damn, okay.
I think LAFC won at the last minute with a free kick from Seaman.
Damn, Seaman.
I
remember all those guys. Seaman, Wynn.
Wynn
in the midfield. I miss him. Like, there was, we had like a good team coming. Yeah, starting.
And I have like, I still have the badge, you know, first game kind of thing.
Oh, badge.
And I think I have a newspaper of like the first game or first victory. But it takes time for you to become like a real fan, I think.
Yeah.
Because going to the game is different, but I have tickets for the supporter section. So I'm always there cheering, singing.
You're there hours before.
Trying to hide from the beer showers.
All beer showers. Yeah.
I don't mind it, but I remember I took my mom to a game once and I'm like, I forgot about the beer showers. And it's funny because I was trying to cover her. There was a whole.
How do you forget? We score every game.
I forgot about the beer showers. The and she got a lot of the whole beer. She got a whole.
No way.
But she didn't mind. I thought it was hilarious.
That was crazy.
I love it. I feel like I'm pretty committed because I mean, from Santa all the way to LA, and they have a game tomorrow.
Yeah.
So sometimes there's times where I don't want to go because just to drive, I have stuff to do. But when I do go, I love it. I try to get there as early as possible just to
experience it.
Well, I don't know if you knew, but if you sit in the supporter section, we have like our own bar in a way. So you get $5 beer.
That's what I hear.
Before the kickoff.
Yep.
So like 2 hours there. So I always go for that.
Of course.
That's the main thing.
You spend $30, you're wasted.
Yeah. And my friend's like, why are you trying to go so early? To drink.
Yes, exactly. Plus you have to drink. Like for those listening to this podcast who don't know, the 3252 is the supporters section for LAFC. And it's wild. It's standing room only. Yeah, there are no seats. Yeah. And they're jumping and playing these drums all game. Yes. And I mean, you would need to be drunk. You would need to be drinking to really like enjoy it a little bit.
It's funny because when I took my mom, she wasn't expecting the whole singing and jumping, and she said that she doesn't like soccer at all.
Okay.
So when she got into the whole singing and the dancing, and she's like, I want to go again. I can't wait. The people are nice. And yeah, they are nice. And that's the only thing she remembers, just the singing and dancing. She didn't watch the game.
Don't watch the game. And I, a lot of people in that section don't watch the game. Nope. I watch them, and they're like, yeah, you know, like, dale. Okay, so I actually planned this because I wanted to ask you about this. And I did not know you. I thought you were a first year. So, like, this is even more important for me. The chants. Do you know all the chants of the 3252?
No, I don't know all the chants. We're going to do it together. They're difficult because, actually, they're easy, but difficult at the same time because I don't know if they change the words or not. But they're easy to follow. All you got to do is listen.
Yeah.
My favorite one are the, what is it? The shoulder to shoulder when you guys, you know, when we get as a group and we just start like going left and then right.
Good. Yeah. I think that's forever more. Like the LAFC, glum, 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 glum. And then you go,
That's my favorite one.
Yo, okay. So we're going to do that one right now.
Oh, right now?
Yes, we're going to do it right now. We're going to play it. It's 24 seconds. And like literally, I was like, you know, doing some research because I don't know. Some of them are in Spanish. And so I was thinking like maybe that's why I don't know them or something like that. But they're pretty freaking easy. So, all right, we're going to go through for the first one. And it literally.
Do you have the lyrics?
Where are the lyrics at? LAFC, we will adore. The North End sings forevermore. And then sha la 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 la. So it goes like this. For the people at home, we turn it up one time. See, they cut it off. Damn website. That's not it, huh?
Oh.
All right, don't worry. We got four more chants. So there's Jump for LA Football Club, which is...
It's funny because I didn't even know the names. I just sing when they're singing.
Jump for LA Football Club, ole, ole. I did not know that was that.
I think it's that one.
You think it's that one? Let's hear it. Jump. They need to make a longer version of that. Okay, legit.
I love it, hate it because it's a workout.
It is a
workout. Because I'm jumping, you know, and it goes like 6-7 times.
Bro, they go forever.
And I'm out there sweating. I think I almost got a cramp once. That's how intense it is.
Okay, no, and it literally says start jumping.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, I like that one. That one's my I thought Dale Black and Gold would be my favorite, which I'm going to play real quick because this is literally the only one, like, I heard it. I started singing it and I was like, this is one of my favorites, but. I just like the Dale.
Black and gold.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, LAFC. Okay, so wait, like, was there no specific story about Galaxy? Why, like, they were just not calling to you? You just kind of felt it in your bones?
I don't know. It just, I tried. Like, really wanted to. I really wanted to get an MLS, but I was like, I'll wait for something to happen. Maybe something will come up.
Yeah.
And LAFC came by. But I don't, and it's funny too, because there's those fans that hate Galaxy, and
yeah.
I mean, I don't hate them. I don't like them. They're like whatever's. But I do like Seattle. I actually like and hate Seattle because for some reason, before Seattle, yeah, I feel like we have a good rivalry with them.
Yeah,
they're good. I feel like they light up when we play
for
against
sure,
them.
For sure.
And when I went to one of their games, and it's a similar experience to LAFC. But I think LAFC fans are a little bit wilder, like when it comes to, like, I think
I feel
more of the passion when I'm there at the game.
Yeah.
At the Seattle one, they sing and they jump, but it's not the same.
I think the stadium's a bit bigger.
Yeah. Oh,
it's definitely. I mean, it's a lot bigger.
Yeah.
They do have a good culture out there, but like, I don't think, bro, there's not a lot of supporter sections like the 3252. I've not seen anything quite like that.
I actually went to a Portland Timbers game.
And they're like sawing the fucking thing.
Yeah, I saw that. I remember I saw it too. I was like, oh shit. And I went by myself, and they're not the loudest, but I feel like they have more traditions when it comes. There was this thing. It was so weird. I can't remember exactly what they were doing, but one of the guys next to me is like, oh, you got to get out your keys. And like, I think it's to make noise. Like they go like this.
Yeah.
And it's supposedly,
but it's like the full stadium's doing that.
No, it's like the supporters.
Okay.
But like supposedly, when you do this, you're making noise while the announcer is announcing the players of the other team. Which is weird. Which is like that's
strange.
I mean, I thought that was kind of cool, but that's something I never expected.
That is cool. That's like a nice home cultural thing.
And everyone was doing it. I was surprised. I was just like,
did you start doing it? Were you?
Yeah, I was doing it. I wanted to be part of it.
Were they like screaming too, or
no,
just?
No, it's just the keys.
That's crazy. Yeah. Okay, that's something cool to like look forward to. Yeah, I need to. I do want to go on kind of like an MLS tour and see like some of the best stadiums around. So it seems like you've been to like some of the best.
I went to Colorado too to go see the Rapids.
The Rapids. How was that?
What does that mean?
It's funny. I don't want to make fun of them, but. It's nothing bad, but I went with one of my friends, and you know when you go to LAFC games, people cuss and scream at the players. In Colorado, they don't. I think the worst thing that they do is boo. Like they'll boo you. That's it. Boo.
Yeah, like boo.
Yeah, that's it. And I'm on. Look at my friends. Like,
who are these soft ass fans?
Yeah, like, we be cussing at the players, but they're really nice. They're actually really nice people, and their supporter section was very small. I think when I went to one of the games, it was like maybe 20 people.
Yeah.
I mean, they have the team, but I don't know what it is that I feel like they could do more.
Yeah.
And they have like a weird mascot. I don't know what it was. Oh, it's actually a rapid.
It's a rapid. But it looked like. Wait, what is a rapid? It's like a mountain? Like a mountain stream?
I want to say it's a water.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but they had like an actual like costume guy.
Yo.
It looked like, how do I explain it? I don't even know. It was some guy with shades, blue, with the jersey.
Oh my God. Mascot Rapid Man. That's is creepy. That what his name was? That's going to haunt my dreams, dude.
I'm telling you, when I saw it, I was like, no. I've never seen that. And when I saw it at the game, I was like, no, that can't be.
Oh my God.
I think that's like an old.
He has an OG Rapid Man. Yo, that would honestly haunt my dreams. I don't know what. So he was just like running around and.
He was just, you know, shaking people's hands, taking pictures of them. And I was like, what is this? And then I was like, oh, Rapids.
Rapids.
Okay.
Water.
Yeah.
So he's Waterman. Yeah. Okay, cool.
But it's a nice stadium. It's
people
are nice.
Is it a football stadium or is it just for their stadium?
Yeah,
it's
soccer? Just for them, yeah.
Wow. Wait, let's go on the tour. Where else you been?
Well, I've been to NRG Stadium, but I didn't go see a Houston Dynamo game. I was there. I was doing photography for this page I was managing, and I wanted to volunteer to go to the Gold Cup, Mexico versus Costa Rica semifinals.
Mm-hmm.
And it was amazing. I was like, I can't believe I'm doing photography at a Mexico game.
Yeah.
And it was crazy. And I think I still remember when Mexico won during penalties, and I saw Ochoa block a penalty for to go to the finals, and I was like, damn. I was like, it's like that dream that as a sports fan, like you want to be there, but I never thought I'd be a photographer doing a game.
Absolutely.
And then it's like, I felt like I was a player, and I was looking around the stadium, all these people cheering, and I was like, I'm really here.
Yes.
I'm like really here. And it was probably the best experience because I was actually going through a really hard time, like in life. And then when I went there, I feel like, oh, okay.
Just changed.
I changed. Bro. I went back with more positive mindset and I was like, I can do a lot more for sure.
Yes. Yeah. So it's the small things, things. The heartbeat of Eat, Pray, Ball is just like, there are certain things within the sport, at least, that have like changed my life, you know what I mean, and like for the better. And it's like it's just those little moments, and you can't, you know.
I asked this guy. I felt weird because before the whole TikTok thing, I don't like taking pictures of myself or asking people to take pictures of me. But now I feel like I'm more comfortable like in camera or like, hey, can you do this?
Yeah.
When I went to the Sounders game, I asked this girl, hey, can you take a video of me for like 10 seconds for a TikTok? I don't want to tell you the whole concept, but it's because it's hard to explain. But just that's it. Just record me.
I'll be here. Yeah.
She's okay. So, but yeah, it's I have a lot of memorable moments.
Yeah.
Like, when it comes to soccer.
Yeah. How did you get into like social media, like content page, photography, all this? Like, is this all encompassed in kind of your social media work?
Well, It all started in college. I was actually a mechanical engineering major, but then I didn't want to do that.
Fuck that.
I was really good at math, physics, science. I was good at it, but okay. I didn't have passion for it.
Yeah.
So I switched to business. I found marketing. I joined a club. I started doing social media, and then from there, I feel like it took off. I got into just social media. I found this post on LinkedIn where I was managing also an El Tri page.
Mm.
And I feel like I was learning on the way, and then TikTok came out. And when TikTok came out, I was like, I'm not gonna download it. It's weird. And then I got
That's how
it.
I felt.
And I remember I made this video, and it went viral, and I wasn't expecting it. Yeah. But it had nothing to do with soccer. The whole soccer guy thing came up when I did a Mexico video when they lost. I don't know against who. I think it was US. I don't know. But it was basically me subbing myself in, like, I'm a show.
Yes, bro. Yeah. I saw that. You were like, nah, when Mexico's playing like this.
I'm going in. I don't give a fuck. I'm going in. I'm tired of fucking losing, dude.
And I remember that the next day I had like 99 plus notifications on my phone, and I was like, what the hell happened? What's going on? And then I saw that, and I was like, and I had to turn off the notifications because I kept going, going, and going.
Yeah.
And people started sending me, hey, is this you? Or my friend of a friend that you don't know sent it to me. So I feel like from then I was like, okay, I like soccer. I can do this more and more. And I feel like it just kept growing on me. And so now I'm trying to do it more, not full time, but more than just a hobby.
Yeah. Like more intent around it. Yeah. I mean, honestly, that's same kind of experience on TikTok. And I got to say, since it's happened, like I did one video on TikTok. It was me hosting a FIFA tournament here. And like I got a bunch of friends to bring their devices. So we had like 4 Xboxes and 4 PSs, and I got TVs all around here. So we were just playing on different TVs. It went crazy. Really? And I was like, man, TikTok's dope. And then I haven't had any video like that go crazy again, but I've slowed down because, and I want to know from your standpoint, how you feel about this, you know, especially being a creator versus maybe a viewer. There's 2 things that scare me about TikTok. One, it was that like immediate like excitement when my video went crazy and I was just getting those notifications. Like I found myself like checking it a lot. And I was like, bro, it's not that serious. Like I didn't get any money from this. Like I should calm down. That, and then like as a viewer, I've logged on to TikTok. Shit, I will give you a personal example. I went on to TikTok this morning to see some of your stuff just so I could talk to you about it. Yeah, bro, this guy has got great content. Once again, if you don't follow El Soccer Guy, bro, this is the guy. But I went on to look at your stuff, and before I could even get to the search bar, something caught me. Like it was a funny video of, I guess it's like a ride at a theme park. It's like a slingshot ride, and like, they just have a camera on the people as they go up. And so it was this woman, and she literally passed out midway up the slingshot. Like it's, I don't know how it goes, but like he goes 3, 2, 1, and he like starts it. And then suddenly there, you see them like,
oh, I think I've done well.
Dude. And she just was like, and it just passed out, bro. From there, like I literally then clicked the page, and he's got a 1,000 slingshot videos, you know, and I just literally, I watched everyone, bro. I looked up, it was like an hour and a half, and I was like,
damn,
this is scary. And I wasn't even going there for that. So, and people have told me, like, more so than an Instagram or a regular social media, like TikTok has algorithms that are like proven to kind of catch you and like hold you there, you know, and it's not even like based on something that like you're looking for. Like my page is soccer, so like I should only be seeing soccer TikToks, but no, it'll, you know, it'll jump out and show me stuff. So I'm just wondering, like, from your thought process, like have you ever felt that or anything? Or
it's
a loaded question.
Yeah, it's like with my work TikTok and then my own personal TikTok, like things do come up that have nothing to do with what I'm following.
Yes.
But then it's cool because some people, and this is what I like about creators, is that they come up with like some eye-catching thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then I see it, and like you said too, like I was like, I'm looking at my phone, it's like, oh, that's cool. And then maybe I look at their profile, and then I went go back and start scrolling, and I'm there, and an hour passes, and it's like, where did this time go?
Where did the time go? Like,
and I'm always online, not because I want to, but I mean, it's my job, and I'm trying to do my own thing, so I have to be there. And I try to take breaks, but it's hard because I'm really trying to create something for myself.
Mm.
And I think it's making it like I think it makes it more challenging for me because I like the challenge of trying to create. I stopped trying to do viral videos, and I feel like I just want to do videos just to entertain people. And
yeah, just for your community.
Because I've tried to make viral videos or something that people will like, and they just don't blow up.
Yeah.
And I did a, you know, I went to Tijuana, I was telling you, and I made a video, which I want to say it's like 100K views. And it's just me watching a video, me saying I'm watching the Manchester United versus Man City when it, in reality it was Cholos versus Querétaro in Mexico.
Wait, were you in the stadium doing it?
Yeah, I was in the stadium. And it did good. And it was just it's just
goofy little video to you, right?
So I feel like some of the videos, I think I guess my message for like whoever's seeing this, it's just, you're not going to get all those views. You're never going to go viral all the time. Yeah. I've tried.
Yeah.
And I've come up with some good ideas. And I'm like, why isn't this going viral or doing better? It just happens or it doesn't. I feel like it'll get to you if it does. But the algorithm, I heard that it keeps changing. That it just, I don't know. I feel like, I don't know if TikTok chooses for you to.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I ask my friends and I'm like, be honest. Is this a good video to you or not? And they're like, yeah, it's good. I was like, I don't understand, you know? Like,
yeah, but 100%. I think it's like it has something. There's no rhyme or reason, no. Right? Like there's no, it's just some things go viral, some things don't.
And I look at other people's videos that I follow or just I see that this video is trending and they have like 500,000 views and their other ones are like 500 or 200 views. So I'm like, I should stop feeling bad for myself.
Exactly. Like, it just happens.
I feel like I pressure myself too much and I just got to worry about creating content. If it works out, it works out. If it doesn't, it doesn't.
No, that's big facts. Yeah, that's tough, man. And maybe that's one of those things. Like when I started to feel like an emotional attachment to it, like I started to really feel disappointed because videos started being, especially like videos you might put a lot of work into.
Yes.
Like, I'm going to shoot this just like this. I'm going to go here. I'm going to maybe spend this money.
Yeah.
And then you're like, why the fuck?
I have like a whole script, like which effect, which song, boom, 20 views.
20 views, motherfucker.
It's like whatever now. Yeah. I try not to feel bad, but I do check my phone and see how every video is doing. And then I get tired because of like, there's too many notifications. I don't even want to.
Yeah, exactly.
I try to reply to everybody because I don't want to be like that guy that just doesn't reply.
Yeah.
So I try to reply to everyone. And I remember I got this comment. Someone replied to one of my videos and I replied back. And like, oh my God, you actually replied. Like, yeah, I try to do it when I can. But it's hard because
this is so much and so fast. Yeah. Bro, I barely respond to text. Yeah. So I don't
need. Oh, really? I try to respond to everybody.
Yeah. No, it's good. Like, I think that's like good engagement too. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I think I've actually maybe posted or laughed or whatever on some of your pages or something. So it's good. Like, and you do like, you'll hit people back in their DMs, like, not just in the comments and stuff. So I mean, that's good. I can't. Like, yo, hit me on Eat Pray Ball for sure. I'll try to get back to you, but if I don't, it's not because I don't love you. It's because I don't, you know, can't do that all day. It's literally scary.
Yeah, I'm already planning like the teams I want to go see.
Really? Yeah.
At least one game in each country.
Yeah.
And maybe like a stadium tour.
For sure.
But Wrexham was on the list because obviously I want to go to England too. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to go see Wolves and Manchester United.
Why Wolves? Because Raul Jimenez?
I don't think he's going to be there like when I'm there. Because they might let him go. He hasn't been doing really good.
Yeah, he's been kind of.
But
Diego Costa hasn't been doing too well either.
Oh,
so,
I forgot he was there.
Yeah. It's like he's literally like the, like, all right, Jimenez. Honestly, ever since Jimenez got that head injury, it's like he's not the same player, which that's so unfortunate.
It makes sense. But I feel bad for him. I feel like if it wasn't for the injury, I think he would have been like a top.
Bro,
top player,
player for sure. Yeah. He'd be like a top striker, you know, because there's not a lot of striking like number nines out there anymore. Like, that's tough. No. It is good. It is good to see like you're following the Mexican players. You're trying to like, you know, you're showing love. You're
it's part of my job, so I have to follow them.
Yeah, okay, that's true. That
so
is
like,
true.
Like for this page I manage, like I'm out at work and sometimes I get notifications. Oh, there's this game about to go on. I was like, oh damn, I didn't even know. So I gotta like, you know, handle all the. I got to know which players are playing so I can like, oh, you know, Jimenez played 47 minutes and, you know, he had an assist. So I got.
Oh, so you
got
to know, like, you're like putting
I'm actually,
stat line
I'm actually posting. So like,
wow.
I clock in kind of thing like, oh, I'm doing this work for this.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I did this TikTok video. And yeah, it's funny too because the page I manage, those people that got me to do this, they found my TikTok and that's how they're like, oh, hey, like we like your stuff. Can you, we want you to manage this page for us. Can you do it? And then like, it's paid. You had me at paid.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, no, it's cool. I like it. And it keeps me busy.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's a good experience for me as a social media guy.
100%.
Yeah, and then I get to meet, like, you know, some other content creators, what they're doing. And I feel like it's something. It's funny too, because a lot of people don't know I do it.
Yeah.
I think I'm just doing TikTok for myself, but I'm like, hey, I got to go to work. I got to do this page I manage. I'm trying to do my own thing. And, you know, trying to meet, like, other people like you.
Yeah.
To, you know, collaborate.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I feel like the more I'm out there, because you never know who you'll meet.
Right.
And then from there, it might lead to an opportunity or just, you know, networking, basically.
That's exactly what I've seen so far, bro. Yeah. And it's just crazy. Like, I didn't, because I didn't know you did that. I thought it was just the El Soccer Guy page. And
yeah, it's funny.
So it probably helps you grow your page because you're doing it in general.
It's funny how we met, too, because I remember you said, like, hey, I know you. And my friend, I remember, she was there with me, like, oh, it's probably him, Leo. It's like, oh, yeah, he's on TikTok. He's like, yeah. I'm like, stop.
I don't remember her saying that, actually. I was like, hey, I know you.
Yeah.
And you were pretty chill.
Yeah.
But then she was like, no, you don't. Don't blow his head up. That's what she was saying.
Yeah, I remember.
Fucking don't say nothing.
That's what she is. And it's funny because you're the second person that recognized me.
At LAFC or just anywhere?
No, just like in general.
Oh, man.
The first time I was going to Mexico City. And I had a stop in Puerto Vallarta.
Mm.
And when I was getting off a plane, you know, to like, you know, go through customs or something, there was this guy, this older guy, and he's like, you go for America. And I'm like, I don't have any America.
Don't have a shirt on, nothing.
I
have nothing.
And I'm like, yeah, I do. Why? He's like, oh, I know you from TikTok. I was like, oh, shit.
Yo, that's when you made it, bro. You're famous now.
I had to cross the border for someone to recognize me. but I thought that was hilarious. And I was telling all my friends, I was like, hey, someone recognized you from TikTok. It was crazy.
Bro.
But yeah.
No, it's kind of a good feeling though, right? Like, no, mine was so organic with you. I had one recognition one time, and I don't have this following you have or anything. Yeah. It was at the World Cup.
Really?
And somebody goes, hey, bro, you're on TikTok, right? And I was like, yo, how'd you know? I felt so good.
Yeah.
Then I realized I had a shirt on that said, follow me on TikTok. So, you know, I'm not there yet. I'm not at pure recognition yet.
I still don't know how to respond to, like, people telling me, like, hey, you're
on TikTok.
Sorry, you're on TikTok.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah. I don't know what to say. Yeah. I don't know what to say. It feels weird.
Nah, that's dope. That's funny. They should have classes on that. Like, what do you say when you get recognized?
I don't say, like, I just be like, oh, yeah, it's me. I still don't know. I feel like it's weird. Because when you told me, like, oh, I know you, it was like.
Yeah, you were like, dude, like,
yeah, hey, yes.
Luckily, I wasn't like too crazy or creepy. Yeah, you know, I was just like, oh, bro, like, I know you. But like, yeah, I know what you mean. Like, no, the way you handle it is super dope, though. Like, you were like, oh, yeah. And like, you were super chill. Like, I honestly expected you to be like, no autograph.
Oh, really? Really?
No autograph, please.
That's something I don't want to do.
You don't want
to. No, because then, like, I mean, I've always heard stories about how people are, like, too cocky or they just don't want to meet people.
Yeah.
And I don't want to be that type of person. I want to be, like, you know, very, like, I'm a very social person. So
yeah.
Like, I always like to meet new people.
Yeah.
And I don't want to get to that level of, like, oh, I made it, I'm famous.
Exactly. Yeah. Nah, bro. You're hella humble. Nah.
Oh, yeah. I try.
This guy, he's the soccer guy, okay?
Yeah.
Well, shoot, bro, I appreciate you coming through. Hopefully I bring you on that. Like, you might be my, like, now that I know what you're doing, like, you're my new Mexico correspondent. Ooh. Like,
I wore the wrong jersey.
But this is dope, too.
Yeah,
like, he's also a jersey correspondent.
Yes.
But U.S. play El Tri, what, March 20 or May 20?
I want to say it's in 2 weeks. They have friendly, I want to say this month, and then they have the...
Nations League, CONCACAF Nations League semifinals in Vegas.
Yeah, there's gonna be a friendly, but I think it's gonna be just local players.
Are you gonna go?
I was thinking about it, but I'm still not sure.
Wednesday, April 19th. Yeah, you're right. That's in like a week.
That's a Wednesday, which makes it even worse. Yeah, I know the semifinals gonna be in Vegas.
Oh, is that where it is? Yeah, the semifinals.
Yeah,
I think that's the one I want to go to. That's the one.
It'll be more worth it, but it's funny because I don't have a bad experience. My friend has a bad experience because he bet money on the Mexico USA Gold Cup, I think 2021. No. Yeah.
Yeah, that was 2021.
And they lost. So he
Mexico lost. Yeah.
So he lost, I want to say, $300-400.
Was that Christian Pulisic PK at the very end?
I think so, yeah.
Where he does.
Yeah. So it sucked.
Damn.
We were pretty down. I mean, my friend was more because he lost money. And I hate making bets because I always, for some reason, I always end up losing.
Bro, I've made so many bets. And it's funny. One of my friends got me into this. We bet jerseys now. We don't bet, like, money. Ooh. You know, it's like.
I might want to get into that.
Yeah, it's not bad, right? It's like not bad. But now, like, I bet that Chelsea would make top four this year, which is like absolutely no. I bet that Liverpool would make top four this year. And I also bet that Arsenal wouldn't win the Prem. Ooh. So it looks like I'm going to be giving out jerseys this year. Yeah, so that one is in Glendale, Arizona. And then we play CONCACAF Nations League semifinal in Vegas, June 15th. Yo, we might have to look into making a little road trip, bro.
I'm gonna hit up Nations League and be like, oh, actually hit them up on Twitter if they can give me free tickets.
Bro.
They never replied.
Keep hitting them up. I'll drive. Yeah? Just say, yo, me and my boy are coming. I'll drive. Yeah,
I'll hit them up again and be like, hey, I hear my story. I'm like, hey, how about this? Do you give me tickets and I'll be there?
Yes. Yeah.
But
yeah.
Make sure you tag Nations League in this.
Absolutely. Hey, yo, Nations League, you got to listen up, bro. You got some serious soccer fans, some serious soccer influencers. Yeah. so, you know, you need us at this game. Like, in terms of brands, what's your top brand?
Adidas.
Adidas all the way. Yeah. Wow, really?
Yeah. Well, here's my experience. I used to be a Nike guy, but...
Checks over stripes.
Okay. Yeah. I always tell people this story. I bought cleats, the Nike Mercurials.
Yeah.
I bought them brand new. Used them for a month, they ripped.
Yep.
And I was so mad. And then from that day, I only picked Adidas. And I bought these Adidas cleats, I think F50s. And they lasted me probably
Comfortable as hell.
Lasted me for like 7 years maybe.
Yeah.
Until they broke literally in half. Yeah. But I still have them as a memory. But that's how long they lasted me. Yeah. And from then, I get gifts from Nike, which I don't mind. I get it.
Nike, no, don't send it to him. Send it to me. What?
No. Gifts. Not from Nike, but from people that are like...
Oh, Nike gift. Oh, yeah. I thought Nike themselves sending like, oh, the soccer guy. Yo,
I don't think I would say no to that.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but like if people, like my friends or family give me like something from Nike, I'll wear
a USA jersey or something like that. Or,
but I think that's actually, as a Barca fan, they're Nike.
They're Nike all the way.
I have to buy, but that's different. It's an exception.
True. And again, Messi's still Adidas. Yeah. And
but all I do is buy Adidas.
That's crazy. My dad is all the way Adidas. I have a story very similar to yours, but this is now why I'm a Nike fan. To your point, my foot is as wide as my hand. My foot does not fit into any shoe. So those F50s were actually really comfortable when I tried them. So I actually wear Adidas cleats more often.
Okay.
But I'm just an overall Nike guy, and here's why. When those Mercurials came out, I think I started... I couldn't wear them in college, but after college I started wearing like Mercurials, whatever it was, either it was Superfly, Vapors. I wore those Cristiano ones, which were like the Superflies too. Then the Neymar ones came out, which were called Hypervenoms, and those were like my favorite cleat. Really? They discontinued those. Anyway, I would rip through shoes literally once every 4 weeks. Ooh. And I played a lot of like pickup and Sunday league out here, but I would just run through cleats. So Nike has this policy that if your boots tear, then it must be a defective product. And if like within 2 months, you can return them and get a new pair.
Really?
Bro, for like a year, maybe 2.5 years, I was basically sponsored by Nike. I would get a new boot literally every month.
Really?
Because I would just send it back up. Oh. These are ripped. And they would just send me a new pair of boots. And like Nike, the way they did it back then, they were like, every 3 months was a new season. Like every quarter was like, you know, all right, now we're going to come out with our colorway boots. Now we're going to come out with our only black boots. Bro, I had new boots, literally. People were like, who the fuck are you? So from then on, just because I was taking advantage of that, Nike was my thing.
Wait, do they still do that?
They kind of do it, but they've gotten hip to like, you have to like really prove that like there's an issue. Yeah. You know what I mean? But again, like their shoes were so bad for my feet that I didn't have to rip them intentionally. I would just play soccer, you know, like 4 or 5 games and hole in the boot. So yeah, Nike, it's because of you guys that I love you guys. It's because of you guys' return policy in 2015 that I love you, but he stripes over checks, man. You gotta recruit him.
Gang, gang.
Gang, gang. All right, bro. I appreciate you coming through. Yeah, this has been great. Bro, yes. Make sure you follow this guy, El Soccer Guy on TikTok. Guy,
that's me.
That's him. If you're watching this on YouTube, please do me a favor. Hit that like button. Smash the subscribe button. You know all the things that they say. Please keep tuning in. It's the EPB Podcast. And we out.